And David Bahnsen, founder and CIO. David B., you know, listen, there's a lot of factors that move the market, but to me, that's the one thing everyone's really concerned about. And of course, President Trump, with the tweets, adds fodder to this, and the media takes it and runs with it.
You're right. It's sort of overall potpourri of uncertainty. I think that ultimately this particular story will prove to be nothing. There's been a couple days since the investigation launched. We saw some volatility. Nothing's really come of it. There would have to be a surprise around the corner. But the idea that the media sort of provoked something out of nowhere, well, geez, where have they ever done that before, right? I mean, I think the sensationalism is baked in. However, I will say this, Charles, there is uncertainty that's legitimate in the market around this trade policy stuff. There needs to be better resolution. The appointment of my dear friend Larry Kudlow was the best news the market's had around that front, but we're still kind of waiting to see how these policies are going to play out.
Well, I'm going to get back to you on that, because about 10 minutes ago, the Washington Post had a story on tariffs that you'll be interested in. David Bahnsen, I agree. I honestly think the media likes the market turmoil. I mean, you know, if someone, maybe Media Research Center will do a piece on it. The amount of coverage on the way up versus the amount of coverage on the way down. I guarantee you the small amount down vis-a-vis the rally would probably astound us, although it probably wouldn't either.
No, I think you're right. But I think that primarily what drives a lot of the left-wing media is sensationalism in general. I don't think that their coverage of this story is driven by trying to disrupt the market. I think that becomes a partial consequence, but just overall creating a fake, like she said, a fake news story around there being disarray. But the idea that an investor would actually take P's and Q's from a reporter reporting that a Republican talked about what would happen if this happened is, first of all, silly. But second of all, it's really, really scary to think somebody would actually do that. Our job is to keep people from responding to noise. That's all this is noise.
David, a $60 billion tariff on China by the end of the week, would that, think that'd be devastating for the market?
It all depends on the details. Just like we saw before with steel and aluminum, we have to unpack it all more. I'm optimistic that cooler heads are going to prevail. Some things are going to get done. He needs to keep showing he's trying to deal with things that need to be dealt with.
Right.
But I don't think they're going to go the whole distance.
All right. Thank you all very, very much.